हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर फिफ्थ न्यूमेरिकल ऑफ द टॉपिक फ्लो मेजरमेंट एंड दिस न्यूमेरिकल इज बेस्ड ऑन पीटॉट ट्यूब। सो लेट अस रीड आउट द न्यूमेरिकल फर्स्ट। अ पीटॉट ट्यूब इज यूज्ड इन एरोप्लेन। यू ट्यूब वाटर मैनोमीटर कनेक्टेड टू इट शोज डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ 10 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ वाटर। Find air velocity means flow rate of the velocity. So it will be in meter per second. Now this is water manometer used in this case. You tube water manometer. You have to use density of the water. So if density of water is not given in the question, then you have to. Sorry, this is not density of water, this is density of air. So if density of water is not given in the question, then you have to take the standard value, that is rho of water will be equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. What else is given? Density of air is given 1.2 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, and h, height is given as, in the mercury manometer, height is given as 10 centimeter of water or 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter of water. Okay, this is given in the question. Now flow rate in the Pitot tube, as we derived the formula in the theory part, will be equal to two delta p by rho. Here rho is the fluid which we desire to measure the flow rate, right, velocity. So two delta p of rho here. Now delta p we need to calculate delta p. So how will you calculate delta p? We know that delta p is nothing but rho g h. This is the formula. Okay, delta p will be equal to, and delta p is measured with the help of u tube water manometer. That's why we are using this formula. Okay, now rho here you can take direct rho as 1000 kilogram per meter cube, rho of water. Or if you remember when we were studying pressure measurement, yeah, when we were studying pressure measurement, then delta p we have derived rho of meter, rho of liquid or fluid V, which we desire to measure the pressure, and g into delta h. So this is h is nothing but delta h. This is nothing but delta h. Okay, that's what the YouTube manometer shows as output. Okay, so rho m minus rho l divided by g into that. Rho m was for mercury, density of mercury. Now at the place of mercury we are using water, so at the place of rho m we have to use rho w. Okay, and the liquid or the fluid which we want to measure the velocity or pressure is air. Okay, so I'm writing A here. So let us change the notation here. This is rho of water, that is rho w, rho of air, that is rho A. Okay, g is 9.8 meter per second. Now delta p will be equal to rho of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube minus rho of air. Rho of air is given 1.2 kilogram per meter cube. D is 9.8 meter per second square. Delta h is given in the question, that is 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter of water. So it will be 10 to the power minus 1. 10 to the power minus 1. So if you direct use rho gh and at the place of rho just use the density of water, that is 1000, then there will not be much difference in delta p in both the cases, right? Because 1000 minus 1.2 and only 1000, there will not be much difference. Okay, so you can directly use 1000 into 9.8 into 10 to the power minus 1, or you can use the accurate formula, that is rho of water minus rho of air into g into delta h. Okay, so delta p will be equal to, calculate this with the help of your calculator. I'll write directly. Okay, calculate this and write the value of delta p. Okay, so delta p should come out as 978 point something, 824. This is pressure, so it will be Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square or Pascal. This should be your delta p. Please verify this. The delta p after the calculation will be 978.824 Newton per meter square. Okay. Now you have delta p, you have rho air, then velocity of the air can be calculated from the formula of Pitot tube, that is equal to v will be equal to under root 2 delta p is 978.824 divided by rho of air is 1.2 kilogram per meter cube. So this will be 1.2. All the units are in MKS system. So calculate V from here. Use your calculator and calculate V. Calculate V. Okay? And write the direct value. So V should be equal to 40.4 meter per second. 40.4 meter per second. Verify it. The answer should be 40.4 meter per second. Now your homework is, you have to verify the answer when you are using approximation. Approximation will be that you are using only rho w g into delta h, means you are neglecting density of air here. Okay, so delta p will be rho w g into delta h, so 1.2 will be diminished, so delta p will be 1000 into 9.8 into 10 power minus 1. So your answer should be, you will be getting delta p something. Okay, now put the delta p value in this formula and calculate v. So let's see what will be your answer. Okay, verify from this one and calculate error. Okay, thank you.